changing the bowling now. Aftab actually bowling. It looked like Govan and Nevin was going to take the new ball, but obviously a last minute change. Whether that's actually part of the plans from Mohammed Nabi, or whether he's decided to change on the hoof.
I think one man they like to get early is Hazrat Zazai, the way he's batted, because he can really get runs in the first six overs in the power play. So probably thinking otherwise, that's the reason Aftab has been brought in. Really bowled very impressively in the Asia Cup as well against top teams in the world. So he's got that knack of picking wickets. The field setting for him, a deep mid wicket, long on, and near the square leg empire as well, with that headband, his famous headband, Aftab Alam. Slow delivery start where that's put away. Oh, diving in way, and that's going to be the four. Four here for Zazai, the first four for him.
Yeah, good shot. Too much width on display there. And this boundary, this outfield very quick, the boundary very short, and it doesn't take too much hitting. If it clears that infield in the power play, it's definitely going to go for four. Actually, just watching Hadratullah here, the similarities, I'm sure there have been many similarities to Chris Gayle made because he hits sixes. But actually, the way that he bats, the way that he's looking in to score in particular areas is very similar to Chris Gayle. Clearly, Chris Gayle has played a lot more cricket, but actually, the way they go about batting is very, very similar.
Got that big 100 versus Nangar. Once again, not at the pitch of the ball, just making room for himself. We'll just pick up one more run. I think the big thing about him also, Dougie, is that the bat throw, the bat speed is so tremendous. Now see the surface, looks to be a very good one. This is the same surface where the first semi-final was played. And I think the curator and the ground staff out here have done a great job because, 23rd game, back-to-back, never easy. Just two strips, two surfaces out here in the Sharjah ground. And still the binding is so good on this wicket. You can see the sheen, the famous Sharjah sheen, the wicket.
Yeah, it's probably less of a mirror than it was when the tournament started, but you can still see shiny. And actually, when you stand on the wicket and touch the grass is very soft, which generally will tell you the ball should come on really nicely. It is a phenomenal effort to play 23 matches and still to be producing a pitch like this one.
Not timing it too well. That should be taken. And yes, that's the first wicket. Luke Ronke won't be happy. Aftab striking straight away in his first over. Going for the big one. Probably coming from the toe end of the blade. And Luke Ronke, after a bright start in the first over, has got to walk.
Abhi, batao, tumko raja kyun banaye?
Ammi Jaan kehti thi, koi jungle chota nahi hota.
I will build a wall.
Hey, madam ji, hame raja bana de, hum gaate hain bahut acha. Chal bhai, shuru ho ja.
Main jungle ka naksha badal dunga. Main yahan pe ghaas phoos lagwa dunga. Main chhed rodi ek hi ghaat mein pani
piyunga. Imam raja bana de.
Abhi, दीवार से लगाया जा रहा है।
नगर का राजा बदलने का वक्त आ गया और ये राजनीति करनी मैं अपनी खिदमत देने को तैयार हूँ। टेक अ ब्रेक।
Once again, a promotion for Wade Parnell coming at number three. He's played a few good knocks coming at number three for the Kabulswanan. He's a good striker, decent player, really can tong the ball hard. 145 is strike rate so far in the APL, 42 is best. That came at number three. Aftab, of course, striking early. Important wicket. Luke Ronke can be very dangerous with the bat. Another left-hander walks in. So two left-handers out there now, Dougie.
Yeah, and that might actually play into Bulk Legend's hands. They might go an extra over with the off spin, trying to beat the outside edge of the bat. We haven't seen any spin so far, but then again, Mohammed Nabi didn't try to spin the ball. Wayne Parnell is better than a pinch hitter. He's a very, very dangerous batter up front. Starting with a bouncer. Aftab showing his intent straight away. Sometimes a difficult thing to do, going in there as a bowler who actually hits the ball really hard, because as a coach or a captain, you need to get bat on ball. You know that the power play is a very good time to score through the field. You don't always have to be looking to score over the field. Sometimes if you go in there as a pinch hitter, if you like, the temptation is to try and get the ball airborne, maybe just a little bit too early.
Once again, take up inside edge there. We'll pick up one more run there. Good
Shahid Ashraf does really well. Another man who's been very impressive on the field with the ball. Picked up some important wickets for Shahid.
Yeah, he's got round the boundary very well. Ran a very good angle there. If he'd gone round the boundary boards, the ball would have probably gone for four. He ran a very good angle to pick it up and probably saved an extra run. Good fielding.
But this is the kind of start you want, especially after the first over where Mohammad Nabi conceded 10 runs. You have got in a wicket, important wicket of Luke Ronchi. Can be such a dangerous player up the order. Once again, slow delivery. Good variation of pace. Looking for that single. Just sent back in time. All happening. Two overs gone. 16 for one.
My name is Mangu, Mangu, John Mangu, the washing machine.
मैं बच्चों को लेके आया हूँ क्योंकि इतनी अच्छी क्वालिटी की उर्दू फिल्में कम आती हैं इसलिए बहुत जरूरी है कि बच्चों को अपनी एनिमेटेड मूवीज भी दिखाई जाए
बच्चों के लिहाज से बड़ों के लिहाज से हर एज के मुताबिक यानी अच्छी है मूवी
बच्चों के लिए बहुत इसमें वो चार्म था बहुत
ही अच्छी मूवी है और फनी मूवी है और बच्चों और बड़ों सबके लिए
और जितनी भी ऑडियंस हमारी घरों में बैठे आई वुड जस्ट सजेस्ट कि निकले बाहर स्पेशली वीकेंड पे बच्चों के लेके आए और ये मूवी बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग है जरूर देखिए
सब दोस्तों को मेरी फिल्म पसंद आ रही है
आपने नहीं देखी क्यों नहीं देखी अभी मेरी फिल्म देख के आए
फॉर हिम लीडिंग रन गेटर्स Mohammad Shahzad, what a treat when he's on song. Going to be Mohammad Nabi once again. Slip in place as well. Now he'll board those off-spinners, isn't it, Dougie?
Yeah, that's the danger of two left-handers at the crease. Nabi can bowl these off-spin, and you can see that the ball just gripping a little bit. It hasn't spun massively, but that's the first ball that he's actually tried to spin, and there's certainly been a little bit on offer there.
Against the right-handers, he was curving the ball away like an outswinger, but now, of course, his usual stuff. The off-spinners, the ball just gripping. He's got to be careful, Wayne Parnell. He's a good striker. He's a decent bat. Oh, that struck. Straight to the fielder. Bit of hesitancy in the end, all's well.
Yeah, good single there. Slightly off over and then there as well. I think the offside field, I think it's... they're looking to try and squeeze anything possible. Nabi to meet the outside edge of the bat. Chris Gayle standing and slip. Any map. But again, they're looking to try and squeeze these Cowboy batsmen for every single run.
Put his mind, Mohammad Nabi, that yesterday they scored really well. Kabul, the way they batted, they came back very well, scoring 192 in the semi-final against the Paktia Panthers. They have the depth in batting. Colin Ingram really batted well along with Rashid Khan. They would like to restrict them under probably 170, 160 because chasing anything over 180, 190 in a final, Dougie, the pressure is different.
I think chasing anything over 140 in a final might be tricky. Scoreboard pressure does really strange things to people.
Yeah, you're right. That's the reason he opted to bat. Get runs on the board. That's a good strike. Very good effort. That might be an effort. But diving there. Just thought probably... he's done a very good job out there. Just checking with the third umpire.
Well, if it is going to be only two runs, well, it's these small margins that make a huge impact in the game. Very good fielding from the youngster.
He's done well. Three overs gone. 19 for one. First inning score goes up, Dougie, and the APL is low scoring games, some high scoring ones, but the average score 172.
You know, they'll certainly be targeting more. more than 170. If they can get one of these batsmen in and established at the crease, watching the first two or three overs, it looks like the ball's sticking in a bit more than what it has done previously to this point in the tournament. And you know, pitches that they've had a lot of traffic on them, and the ball, if you do ball into the wicket, the ball sometimes comes out slightly different in speed, and that may be making it to the wicket.
First inning scores, Dougie, in the APL is 172. So that's from the other end. The average first inning scores, Dougie, in the APL is 172. So that shows the kind of surface it is throughout. We've had some low scoring games, some high scoring ones, but the average score, 172.
You know, they'll certainly be targeting more than 170 if they can get one of these batsmen in established at the crease. They are capable of way more than that. But this pitch, even just watching the first two or three overs, it looks like the ball's sticking in a bit more than what it has done previously to this point in the tournament. And you know, pitches, they've had a lot of traffic on them. And the ball, if you do ball into the wicket, the ball sometimes comes out slightly different speed. And that may be making it slightly more difficult for the batsman. Interesting to see the lengths that the bowlers have bowled so far. Into the wicket, trying to target the top of the stumps.
Giving much pace to the batsman. He's bowling those slow deliveries, those cutters. They're exactly what he does very well. And the death overs, both those yorkers, Aftab Alam. He's bowled some very good spells for his side. The captain having a lot of confidence in his abilities. Hasn't taken too many wickets. 2 for 14 versus Bhakti, against Dhangar as well, 2 for 26. But he's been economical.
Oh, there we go. Just slow a ball to a bouncer. And that's exactly what you need to do as a brave bowler in this format of the game. You need to be showing the batsman that they can't line you up. And that's exactly what Aftab has done there. It's the second bounce we've seen him bowl, and it's a good one as well. You talk about, if you're going to bowl a bouncer, make sure you get it up in between shoulder and head high, and that's exactly what he's done.
He's got a man at deep square leg. The fine leg inside the circle, that's Chris Gayle. Oh, that's a good delivery. You see the way he alters his length. Very clever. Good stuff here from Aftab Alam.
Yeah, like I mentioned a minute or two ago, the danger of playing a pinch hitter is they just can't get bat on ball. Which, you know, it's all well and good hitting sixes and fours, but if you're not rotating the strike in between, you're going to leave yourself short. It may be that the pitch is slightly more difficult than what we can see from here, but not making contact is a bit of a cardinal sin from a batsman at this stage.
What it does for the side is it adds to the depth of the batting, because you have someone, you know, even if he gets out, doesn't matter. But you're right, you know, losing up probably on a few deliveries, because he's taken his time now, Parnell. 2 of 10, exactly what the bulk legends are looking at, just to tie him up initially, stem the flow of runs, not give him easy runs. It's an important over, remember, the power play in progress. There's two fielders out to the circle.
Yeah, and the most successful batsmen for Kabul have been the likes of Laurie Evans, Colin Ingram, Rashid Khan. And what you're doing is by playing... Oh, no, this might be a run-out opportunity. Oh, they've got home. Not the best throw from Nabi. Scampered through for a single. After 4 overs, 20...
Watching the proceedings, it's been a great effort by everyone. Let's associated with this Gulbahar Afghanistan Premier League first edition. Of course, we are in the final game, big game here. Mohammad Nabi has done very well. And I think great thinking as well, Dougie, that he's persisting with himself. Bowling his third over now, just seeing both the left-handers out there. Barnell struggling a bit. Very good move here from the captain.
Yeah, that's impressive. It's just stopping a little bit. And it's very difficult to wait from your outside edge. If he's bowling straight, you have to be taking a chance. And that's gone straight up in the air. It's going to be a good catch by Nabi. Yes, great catch. And the second wicket. And that's a big wicket as well. Hajratullah, the danger man in this partnership.
My name is Mangu Mangan Mangu.
ताकि ये फिल्म जिन पॉलिटिशियन ने देखी है वो इससे इतने मुतासिर क्यों हुए हैं
मैसेज ये लेके कि एक डोंगी भी बहुत अच्छे से कंट्री को लीड कर सकता है रूल कर सकता है अगर वो करना चाहे तो
ये जो फिल्म है कि भी आने देने वाले दिनों में जमहूरियत के हवाले से सियासत के हवाले से तर्ज हुकूमत के इसका हवाला दिया जाए
जैसे आपने क्लियर नहीं किया सियासतदानों को ऐसे हम भी नहीं कर सकते
एक क्लेवरली डन बैन तो नहीं हो जाएगी
डोंकी किंग कौन है
मुझे पता है पर मैं नहीं बताऊंगा
डोंकी किंग जबरदस्त डोंकी किंग ऑसम
सब दोस्तों को मेरी फिल्म पसंद आ रही है आपने नहीं देखी क्यों नहीं देखी फिल्म देख के
Ingram, he walks in, played yesterday in the semi-final, just coming back into form, such a good fielder as well, 185 runs for him in the AP. Playing in the air, does pretty well on occasion, Parnell making a move on, that's a maximum, fog maximum.
Yeah, that's a big shot there. Parnell just lost the wicket of the ball before. At the time, he's actually looking to go for spin, which is what Hajratullah didn't do. He went across the line of a spin on that occasion. Straight over mid-off, and a beautiful six straight into the crowd.
Exactly how he's got to go about. Once again, getting a bit of turn. That was the off-spin. Nicely, Mohammad Nabi. That one just gripping the surface, I felt.
Yeah, very much gripping in the surface and coming out very slowly as well. It makes it very difficult for these batsmen. I think they need to learn from the wicket of Hajratullah. And when they're playing spin, it's very important, I feel, that they actually go with the spin. They can still hit the ball for four and six, but it makes it difficult if they're going against the line of the spin.
What he did on the last occasion was bring the mid-on fielder up inside the circle, the long over. Was back once again varying his pace. This was the wicket of Hajratullah Zazai. Goes for the big one, never getting that elevation. Immediately knew that he was in trouble there. The ball just curling above, but he does very well. Cool as a cucumber, and he's done a very good job. Decent overs from the captain straight away with the new ball. Bowling his third one, 1 for 23. Ingram on strike for the first time. Good delivery. Good over. Five gone is 30 for two. He's got the knack of picking wickets, done really well. 13 wickets for him, Dougie. This year they call me wonderful. Bowls of the death, 4 for 19 is best. So what a player he's been for the bulk legends.
And he's a pretty handy bowler coming in at 30 for 2. I think the bulk will be the happy of the teams at this stage. And he controls his power play to this point. It'll be interesting to see if the batsman Wimpa knows how to do a job. If you look to try... presser and not let Ashraf sort of settle into his role.
That's good effort. Very good commitment. Throwing it straight away. Ball. That's the way important.
It is. I feel that that his thumbs may have been a run out. Absolutely. Colin Ingram had given that up. But and the throw was wide. It wasn't accurate. So they scamper through for a single.
But the thing about the Abu's ideas have someone like Laurie Evans, Rashid Khan. Really well coming in the middle order. Laurie Evans are so consistent with the bat, and you have been his coach as well this season, Dougie.
All down to me. Yeah, no, I'm delighted for the way Laurie Evans has played. I was coaching him at Warwickshire for 6 or 7 years, and he's done very, very well. As we just look at the most wickets in the tournament, Udana having a fantastic tournament, 17 wickets.
And you see that graphic. It's a very interesting graphic because you mentioned about Ashraf, of course. Udana has been special for the Paktia Panthers. No bowler from Kabul features there. So that's a big surprise for me. You know, because shows that really the wickets have been taken by the Balangidges bowler, Gulbadin Naib. You mentioned about him. Ashraf has been very successful as well. But no bowler there from the Kabul side.
That's a very good point, but they'll be looking towards their top performance. Rashid Khan, you would think, will be licking his lips watching this pitch behave the way it's behaving. You know, it's slow and spinning a little bit. He has that mystery. He's performed really well in this format, in all formats, but all over the world. And they'll be looking for him to make best use of this surface.
Rashid Khan, he's taken 9 wickets, Wayne Parnell 10. Really, they've done well reasonably, but don't feature in that list. The highest wicket taken so far in the Gulbahar Afghanistan Premier League. But Rashid Khan, you know, he rises to the occasion whenever the opportunity is there. Mentioned about, just see, for Kabul, Wayne Parnell mentioned about 10 wickets, Rashid Khan 9. Muslim Musa has done well, 7. Farid Malik at times has bowled really well, chipped in with the important spells, 6 wickets for him. Nicely on the onside. So 6 overs gone, the power play gone, is 34 for 2.
one bounced a long off. So, yeah, pretty useful over. By Muslim Musa. It's 84.
Hard work, and for you it'd be terrific to see the fruition of this. I mean, here we are in the final. We've had some terrific moments. We've enjoyed the league thoroughly, some very close matches as well, which is what it's all about, you know, close matches. Eventually it grabs people, and of course I believe in Afghanistan, people are delighted with what's going on.
I'm sure. I think we have had the best of the matches possible in any T20 league, and the kind of run chases we have had, the kind of six sixes. Sixes in an over. We have had an hat trick, highest run scored in UAE. Then there's another record, highest runs chased in UAE. So I think there's almost half a dozen records we have made in this 23 matches.
Well, how lucky was Colin Ingram there? Terrific delivery by Mirwais, and very full. Colin, for a moment, might have expected it to crash onto his stumps, and he thrashes it again. Will it find the gap? No, still can't. So run making very difficult. It continues to be for couples one on. He's over by Mirwais. And
का छोटा मोबाइल बैग जब भी चाहो पर दिल चुरा लो.
Very importantly, the sport in India and on the many parts of the world. Thank you for joining us in our telecast of this inaugural Gulbahar Afghanistan Cricket Park. I've got Ashley, hear me. Just your partner, the Afghanistan Cricket, you knew, you didn't have any sporting experience before this. And new friends.
It's been a fantastic journey. Again, said thank you to the Afghanistan Cricket Board. They not only handholded us, they mentored us in a very professional manner and a friendly manner. They never realized that we're a startup, and you know, we're doing it. Been very profound supporting. I'm very happy because of Afghanistan.
Absolutely right. I mean, there's nothing short of what's being organized. Of course, Telex itself, Sportsworks from India, done a fantastic job trying to show some of the stars. Behind the camera, all the way through club. And the oh, how wet was that bun? It's been a while. For Saluda, that's what comes one. Finally getting an opportunity. For the news of confession of end, in comes one and supporters. Something to check. This is going to be a tough day. Just from what we've seen so far. By the way, this pair put on 70 against Bulk. Oh, down leg, no Pilar, and they will still a single pretty sharp. And Ashish also four of them. They have great, lots of young stars out there that shot. And it was a terrific stars.
The kind of rotten of has any test playing nation.
So Gulbuddin Naib, who has picked up plenty of wickets, Tarzan we call him. A little expensive in his opening over. Another Fogg Saluriza, that's a boundary. It was drifting down leg full, and all Ingram had to do was put a little bit of bat onto it. Fine leg was inside. And a very welcome boundary yet again. Yeah, he got the timing perfectly right. Of course, we've more Afghanistan cricket, Ashish. Just so many other youngsters showing that they have the hunger.
It's just a matter of you'll have half a dozen of Nabi, half a dozen of Rashids, and much more.
Three, yes! That's three. And then Colin Ingram now in the act. Ingram, time settled down. The pitch,